me today from Silk Logistics is Brendan Boyd. Brendan, good to meet you.
Thank you, Andrew. Likewise.
Brendan, for those not perhaps too familiar with Silk Logistics, give us firstly a bit of an introduction.
Sure. Look, the business was the outcome of a management buyout led by myself and some other executives in 14. We've been undergoing a strategy of growth and consolidation since, culminating in the listing of the business in July last year. Growth from 75 odd million in 14, and this year we'll turn over about 380 odd million with some significant improvement in the performance of the bottom line as well. So it's been a journey.
And give us a bit of detail as to exactly the operations, what Silk does.
Sure. Andrew, we describe ourselves as a tech-enabled, and that's an important feature, port-to-door logistics provider in this country. We only operate domestically, but effectively we move containers from the five major ports through our warehouses and then, as required, to order, pick, and then out the door for a last-mile destination. When you consider the importance of container movement to our economy, we think we play a pretty important role.
Of course, the COVID supply chain challenges, they've all been well documented. To what extent were you impacted?
Yeah, look, like everyone in February 2 years ago, we all went ducking for cover, thinking the worst. But I think what culminated was obviously a real demand for some of those consumer products. We, Andrew, play a key role in food and dairy type segments. So that was obviously, of course, an essential service. And the business, I guess we sum it up, was quite neutral to us. COVID had some challenges, obviously, volatile shipping arrivals, volatile demand patterns, absenteeism, but equally strong consumer demand for the sorts of products our customers were warehousing with us.
So you say the new business pipeline, that's looking strong.
Yeah. Look, as I said, we bet above our weight. I think one of the critical things for our business during the last 2 years is our focus on service and our focus on reliability for our customers has been critical and really resonated, I think, with the market. And we've had our door being banged down by customers wanting to partner Silk. So we think we're doing something right.
What's your market share?
Look, we're a, let's call it a $400 million player in a $60 billion market. And that's just in those three service lines that I talk about. So container movement, warehousing, and then distribution. So we have a lot of room for growth.
Tell me a bit about the recent acquisition here of, was it 101 Warehousing?
Yeah, look, one of the real, I guess, outcomes, one of the real trends from COVID and the impact of it, a number of our traditional retail customers, so Barbecues Galore as an example, are really accelerating their shift into that B2C fulfillment. We're traditionally being what we call a business-to-business provider, and I guess we're responding to some of those customer demands for a different capability, which is really that e-commerce fulfillment. And that's what the 101 acquisition was about.
You said before, there's plenty of headroom for growth. So where are you looking at for opportunities?
Look, we see acquisitions in our port logistics sector, particularly WA, SA and Sydney for scale. We see some more opportunity in that e-fulfillment space. And then we're looking into that last mile distribution space. But equally, I must add, you know, our target over the next 5 years for purely organic growth is around $260 million. And that's really just accessing those opportunities that we see amongst our customer base and/or targets.
Brendan, thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew. Appreciate your time.